Hello students, I am once again back with an English online classes. This is Junaki Biswas and you are watching video number 2, class 5, English course, lesson 1, The Man Who Fought Windmills by Miguel de Cervantes. Dear students, in video number 1, I explained you the summary of the lesson 1 and you all were given the hard words to write 3 times as your home assignment. Now in this video, I will be covering the topic recapitulation of the summary, explanation of the text and home assignment. Now before I go for the recapitulation, I would like to give you a small activity. Do focus here at the board. I have given you 4 words in a jumbled form. You are supposed to rearrange these 4 words. And all these are things which are useful to a knight. A knight is a person who fights for their king. So all these 4 words are related to the warriors. So please take few seconds and try to rearrange these words. So could you find the answer, students? Just see the board once again. The first word, if we rearrange it, it's helmet, which the soldiers wear on their head. The second is armor, which the soldiers wear on their chest to protect it. Next is shield. It's a piece of a metal which the soldiers carry to protect themselves. And the last word is sword, which is used to fight. So students, how are these words related to our lesson? Yes, these words are related to the main character of the lesson, whose name was Don Quixote. He wanted to become a knight and do some heroic deed. He always used to read books and remained in his fanciful world. One day, he, along with his assistant Sancho, went on an adventure. After many days, they came across a big field which had some windmills. As Don Quixote always lived in his fanciful world, he thought those windmills as huge giants and ran towards them to attack them. Before Sancho could stop him, his lance got stuck in one of the blades of the windmill and he fell down with a loud clang. Don Quixote thought that the giants had attacked him. So he ordered Sancho to run and bring his magic powder, which contained potion, a magical liquid. Sancho ran and brought the magic bowl, which was actually filled with curd. Before Sancho could understand anything, his master put the bowl on his head. And what happened? Yuck! The whole curd started dripping on his face. And at the same time, Don Quixote thought that his brain is melting because the giants have cast a spell on him. So Sancho could not stop laughing and he somehow took his master back home. But Don Quixote, before going home, promised to once again come back and fight with these giants when his brain gets fixed up. Now students, this is the small recap of the summary which I told in video number 1. Now, we will be doing the explanation of the lesson. So students, let me introduce you to an English book, The English Channel by Britannica Learning. And the first lesson is The Man Who Fought Windmills. Let me read and explain you the lesson. A long time ago, there lived a man in a castle in Spain. He wanted to be a hero and help people in danger. He wanted to be a knight and ride on his horse dressed in a suit of armor. But the world had changed. There were no knights. Nobody wore shiny armor anymore. Nor did anyone have magical adventures in strange faraway lands. Still, this did not stop Don Quixote. He decided to dress up
in his great grandfather's rusty armor and go out in search of adventure. Once Don Quixote was in his armor and mounted on his bonny old horse named Rocinante. Even his squire Sancho Panza laughed until his sides hurt. However, Don Quixote didn't care. Such was his confidence. "Do you want me to make you the ruler of some distant land, Sancho?" asked the knight. Sancho stopped laughing. "Yes, yes," he cried. "Well, get on your donkey and come with me," said Don Quixote. "We will have some wonderful adventures together." After many days of riding, Don Quixote and Sancho Panza came to a large field.
Students, as I have read, the main character of the story, Don Quixote, he used to live in Spain, in a castle. Now, what is a castle? Castle is a noun word which means a large old building to keep people safe from enemies. I also mentioned that he wanted to become a knight. Knight is again a noun, a soldier who fought for his king. So Don Quixote always wanted to do some heroic deed as a knight. He always wished to wear armor, mount on a horse and go for an adventure. But the world and the time had changed. It wasn't the time where these knights and magical activities or adventures took place. So one day, Don Quixote wore his great grandfather's armor. That means he dressed himself completely like a knight. Mounted, that means sat on a horse, that was a very thin horse, and he came out. Seeing him, his assistant Sancho laughed so much that his side started paining. That means his jaws started paining. Now let us see the meaning. Armor is again a noun word. It means metal clothes that men wore to protect their body. Adventures, noun. Something exciting that you do. Mounted is a verb. To get onto a horse. And bony, it's an adjective. It means very thin, full of bone. And confidence is again a noun. Feeling that you can do something well. So Don Quixote, with full confidence, ordered his assistant Sancho to join him for the adventure. He even told Sancho that he will make him the ruler of a distant land. Do you know what is the meaning of ruler? This word has two meanings. The first one is the wooden or metallic stick which we use for measuring. And the second is a person who rules a country.
"Look at the giants," cried the knight. "What? Giants?" asked Sancho. "Over there, see. Those gigantic outstretched arms. Where?" "I don't see any giants," said Sancho. "All I see are windmills." "There, Sancho, look there." Don Quixote was pointing at the windmills, his eyes round with excitement. His head was so full of magic and adventures that he thought the windmills were giant. "I don't see any giant," Sancho said firmly, hoping to change the mind of his fanciful friend. "You are stupid, Sancho," said Don Quixote. "They are giants and I am going to fight them." Before Sancho could utter another word, Don Quixote charged towards on his horse, lowering his lance. Just as he reached the first windmill, the wind began to blow and the great arms of the mill creaked slowly around. "Watch out, Don Quixote," yelled Sancho. But it was too late. His lance stuck into one of his windmill's blades and he was swept up off his horse and high into the air. He fell with a loud clang to the ground, and his helmet turned the other way on his head.
So both of them set on a long journey. After a few days, they came across a large field which had some windmills. Seeing those windmills, Don Quixote shouted, "Giant, giant!" Why did he shout? Because he thought that those windmills were giant, because he was always in a fanciful world. He thought the arms of the windmills as huge, gigantic, outstretched arms of the giant, and rushed to attack them. The meaning of the words are giant, noun, a big tall person; gigantic, adjective, very big; outstretched, verb, means extend or stretch; and windmills, noun, a tall building with long flat parts that turn with wind. Before Sancho could stop his master, he rushed towards the windmills to attack them. At the same time, the wind blew and the arms of the mill started to move slowly, and the lance got stuck in one of the blades of the windmill, and Don Quixote was thrown away off his horse and he fell down on the ground with a loud clang. The meaning here, crit is a verb. It means high-pitched sound. Lance is a noun. It's a weapon with wooden handle and a pointed metal head. Fanciful is an adjective which means a person who lives in imaginary world. And clang is a noun which means a loud and clear sound.
"Didn't I tell you they were windmills?" said Sancho as he ran to help his friend get on his feet. "They were changed into windmills by magic," said Don Quixote. "They are really giants." Then Don Quixote had an idea. "Quick, Sancho, get me my saddle bag. My magic bowl is in it. I will show these giants they can't fool me." Sancho rushed over to Rocinante and got the saddle bag. He took out the bowl filled as it was with curd. Perhaps Don Quixote had added a magic potion to the curd, he thought. "Give me the bowl," said the brave knight. "I will wear it on my head and turn these windmills back into giant."
Sancho rushed to help his master, but Don Quixote was still not ready to believe that those were only windmills. He thought that the giants had attacked him. He ordered Sancho to rush and bring his magic bowl, because he wanted to again fight with those giants. Sancho rushed and brought back the magic bowl. Magic bowl had potion in it.
"But the bowl's full of." Too late. Don Quixote had already put the bowl on his head. The curd began to drip all over his face. "Help, Sancho, help! My brain is melting. Sancho, my brain is melting. Those wicked giants have cast a spell on me." "Oh, Don Quixote." Sancho couldn't stop laughing. "Let's go home. We will come another day when the wind is not blowing and get those giants," he said finally. "All right, we will go. But just till I can get my brain fixed, I am not giving up. I am a knight and someday I will be a hero."
Before Sancho could understand anything, Don Quixote put the bowl on his head. And the bowl contained curd which started dripping all over his face. Seeing this, Sancho could not stop himself. He started laughing. But do you know what his master thought? He thought that his brain was melting And why? Because the giants, that is those windmills, they have cast spell on him. Sancho somehow took his master back home. But Don Quixote, before leaving, said that he would once again come back to fight with those windmills. Now let us see the meanings. Saddle, it's a noun, a seat on a horse. Actually, the magic bowl was kept in the saddle bag, which Sancho brought. Potion, it's a noun, it's a liquid with magic powers. Wicked, it's an adjective which means very bad. And spell, it's a word which has two meanings. The first is a noun which means magic words, and the second is a verb which means write letter to make a word. And square, which means assist. So students, hope the explanation of the lesson is clear to you all. Now can you tell me, what did you learn from the story? One basic thing which we learned from the story is that we should not live in fanciful world. Now students, let us look at the board. I have given you some home assignments. Number one, you have to give the answer to the question, what did Don Quixote think the windmills were? And number two is page number 3, question number A and B. And number 3 is say it right. Students, you have to do all these 3 homeworks in your English course. The rest of the textual exercises will be uploaded in the parents portal. Thank you.